This video covers the algorithm for finding single source shortest paths in directed acyclic graphs. It's a simple algorithm and I could do a half-assed job of covering it in like 3 minutes, but I'm gonna try to give you both cheeks here. After mentioning prerequisites, we'll see the algorithm idea and the algorithm, including the single target variant. I'll add some more detail and then show how that detailed version works on a slightly screwy example that has some cycles, even though it isn't supposed to, because that can show you how to push the algorithm a little past its boundaries. Before starting this video, you should understand the graph basics, including depth-first search. The introduction to single source shortest paths video is like the first half for videos on Bellman-Ford, Dijkstra's, and this one, and you have to know what topological ordering and topological sorting are for the algorithm here to make any sense. You should also know what lists and stacks are, but that's not as critical. This algorithm can find the shortest distance and shortest path tree from any vertex to all other vertices in any directed, acyclic, weighted graph. It runs in time linear in the graph size and can work as long as there are no cycles reachable from the start vertex. The idea is really simple. Imagine that the shortest path to some vertex V has U as V's predecessor. If we know that vertex U has its correct shortest distance, and then we relax the U to V edge, V gets its correct shortest distance. The problem is we don't know which vertex is V's predecessor when we start. Is it A or C or D or F? I don't know. But if we finish all vertices with an edge to V for each of them, get a final distance and then relax outgoing edges, all before getting to V, for sure that will include V's predecessor. That's actually easy to do here because the graph is acyclic. If you consider vertices in topological order, every vertex leading to V must have been considered before V. Modifying our generic algorithm, relax edges out of vertices taken in topological order. That's the algorithm. If you only care about one destination, stop when you get to it. Topological sorting and this entire algorithm take linear time. You need to know topological order and sorting. That playlist has two different algorithms. You want to use the one based on depth-first search, and you can run it on just the start vertex instead of the whole graph. You only care about reachable vertices. We don't care about start and finish times. We just need the order. Ignoring call stack overflow worries from that video, let's add a depth-first search-based ordering. It returns a topologically ordered list of reachable vertices in reverse order. Here, a stack might have made more sense than a list. We could have pushed and popped, but the list will be more helpful for the next video on the playlist. You should know what stacks and lists are. Just make sure each of those operations take constant time. Now the algorithm takes time linear in the number of vertices plus reachable edges. Notice, I don't have any error check for cycles. That's on purpose and I'll come back to it. If you're making a library routine that's required to reject inputs with cycles, you can run depth-first search, look for back edges, and if you find one, reject the graph. Instead, I'm actually going to run this on an example graph with 3 cycles to see what happens. I hope it'll help you understand how the algorithm works and why it might go wrong with cycles. I'll show you the edge weights for an edge when it gets relaxed. The leftmost cycle, hi, won't cause any problems, because it isn't reachable from the start and we can ignore it. The D to B edge also can't cause any problems as long as its cycle has non-negative total cost. But the F to E edge might hose us. If you prefer a more standard example with no cycles, just cover up those extra edges on your screen with some correction fluid. Okay, once upon a time, correction fluid was used to fix typing mistakes made with typewriters. Okay, typewriters were these machines, just Google it. So in this case, we imagine that we get vertices in the order start, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H and I aren't reachable, they don't make it into the list. Relax outgoing edges from vertices in that order. If this were a real topological ordering, whenever I take a vertex, I know it must already have its correct shortest distance and edge from a parent node, so I highlight that edge. Great, we whip through, start A, B, C. For D, it has an edge to B, but assuming no negative weight cycles, no matter the edge weight, it cannot give a shorter path to B in this graph. Because the only way to get to D is through B. So even though it's a cycle, it won't mess us up. What about when I get to the FE edge? Well, if it weighs 5 like it does here, it doesn't cause problems either. When I relax it, it finds a more expensive path to E, which we can ignore. But if its weight were 2 instead of 5, it would change the distance estimate to E when E was already supposed to be finished, and E's edge to G would need to be relaxed again to find the shortest path to G. Without that extra relaxation, the algorithm would fail. With weight 5, everything works because we happen to get lucky in our vertex order from the depth first search, even though there were cycles. On the other hand, if the depth first search part returned vertices in the order start, A, B, C, E, F, G, D, the algorithm would fail with these weights. We need to check if a relaxation successfully lowers the distance estimate to an already finished vertex. That will happen only if the graph has a reachable cycle and the depth first search part doesn't get lucky in return of vertex order that allows us to relax each edge only once and still know that we have found correct shortest distances. Otherwise, we fail. So here, that discovered flag is used for the depth first search portion of the algorithm, and the finished flag is used for the relaxation part. Why bother with this stuff? If you don't know whether or not a graph is acyclic, and you want to check, that check can take time linear in the size of the graph. If you're just writing code for yourself, or if your algorithm precondition is that you're always given an acyclic graph and you can do whatever you want if it has cycles, you can just try to run this whole freaking algorithm in linear time. Even if there are cycles, maybe you get lucky and it finds correct distances anyway. If that lets you avoid a slower algorithm, it might be worth it. I'll return to that idea in the video on Frankenstein's shortest paths algorithm, but that's it for this one. I have to go. This back ain't gonna shave itself. Please subscribe.